Hey everybody, how you doing? Fio here. Usually as we get to the tail end of a month, I put out everything for the patrons for the next month, and I've kind of gotten to this groove where I post battles for the next month. And I try to plan them out a little bit, and I think about some things that they may want to do and some things that I want to do. And I hope that the two things are the same, right? So out of all of this month, and there's some good stuff on tap, this is kind of the one I'm most excited for. I have not done a box of March of the Machines in half a year? Is that where we're sitting now? At least half a year. Wow. So out of all the stuff that I've opened on the channel, March of the Machine kind of went bye-bye. So because of it, I'm kind of excited. These are prize packs. This is a battle. I'm going to explain then how this all works. I just wanted to preface that aspect of it. I'll admit, I held off because I thought this set was going to go super cheap, kind of like what's happening in the Markov Manor. It didn't. And why? Well, I know I underrated this set, very much so. Interesting how that happens sometimes. So this is a battle. We've got four participants. Each one's going to get three packs out of this box. We're going to add up the mana value of all of their rares and mythics. Whoever's the highest total, whoever's the lowest total, each gets one of those Wilds of Eldraine collector packs, which are packs I love for prizes just because of that ancillary slot. You can get some really neat hits out of Wilds of Eldraine. Super underrated for the price. Anyways, if we have any ties, that'll be determined based off whoever has the single highest casting cost mythic. And if that doesn't do it, highest casting cost rare. And if that doesn't do it, we're rolling dice. All right, so now we got that out of the way. Vincent, J.A., Daniel, and Jacob. All right, good luck, everybody. We're going to do this in three rounds. So first round, first pack. Vincent, you are up. So a lot of cards in this set have definitely slowly found their way to way more play. It's been fascinating. So let's see what we got. Again, it's been forever for me. So Teferi's Talent, Commander card, that is a 5. Grafted Butcher, that is a 7. Vulpine Harvester, you are at an 11. Another Commander card. Firja, Renata, because you get your 2 uncommons. Wrinkle and Torbran. Okay, you are at a 16. And a mythic? Oh, jeez, cool. That's Halo Foil Elesh Norn. Off the, whatever they called these, the Multiverse Legends, blah, blah, blah. That's cool. Oh, sweet. All right, congratulations, Vincent. That's cool. All right. Yeah, that was fun. All right, what are we at? 16 plus 7 is 23. It's not that hard. All right, there we go. Congratulations, Vincent. You do tend to get one mythic in the Halo foil per box, and that's the one. Hopefully, maybe we'll get a second. I don't remember that really being a thing. I remember it primarily being one per box of the Halo mythics. But maybe we could find one of them serial number things that I forgot existed for a second. And I did not go into this thinking serial number card. Hey, Surge of Salvation. Really, I thought I went into this more of the that the set itself has had more playables and the multiverse legends are still kind of neat. Dusk Legion Duelist. So J.A., that is a 2. Inga and Asika. Okay, that is a 6. Mirror Style Master, you're at a 12. Rada. Dina in the Halo. Nahiri's Warcrafting, you're at a 15. And Atris for a 19. Yeah, March of the Machine as a whole is going down way better than I thought it was going to, I'll admit. In fact, I think I even shared as much back then. You know, not everybody's always right about everything. And I'm definitely not always right about everything. All right, Daniel. I know when the set first came out, I was not in love with it, and then I've grown to appreciate it more, so much so that I even started eyeing it up. I'm like, I should open more for me. Nahiri's Warcrafting for a 3. Transcendent Message, you're at a 7. Blight Titan, kind of neat, you're at a 13. Timeret, Inga. Okay, we got our Mythic, we got Kroxa and Kurunaros. Kroxa, sorry. So that is a 19. Hey, and a Halo Foil Brutaclad. Okay, That is a 25. I've forgotten. You get like, is it kind of like the stepping complete? Ah, it's been so long. Is it like the stepping completes where I can kind of expect to get a couple rares in the Halo foil? I do not remember. So that's a 25, Daniel. I did forget that this was a pretty high casting cost set. Okay, Jacob. Let's get into this. Glizzy. That is a 5. Sunfall. Solid pull. That is a 10. Extended Art Sunfall. One of the cards that's been seeing lots of play. Cutthroat Negotiator. That is a 14. Raph. Firja. Okay. Moria into Char, Commander Mythic. You're at a 19. And Ayara for a 22. So first round in. We've got Daniel in the hide at 25. Vincent is at a 23. Jacob is at a 22. And JA is in the low at a 19. And I just did that in a really weird order. All right, Vincent, you're up. Next pack. Vision of Lorwyn, okay. Hoarding Broodlord for an 8. Okay, the Guardian of Garoper. Garoper? I have no idea. All right, that is an 11. Chivalric Alliance for a 13 out of the Knight deck. Quende. Emati in Halo. The Halo is not as strong in this one because they didn't put it in that area. So it doesn't show up as much. Transcendent Message in Extended Foil. And Tygum. Bojutai Master Showcase Foil. Hold on. What were you at? 21. So Vincent, you are at 21. We still got a bunch of mythics to go in this box. So far we are at what? 3 mythics in total? 1 commander mythic, 1 regular set mythic, and 1 mythic from the Multiverse Legends. So a bunch more to go. All right, JA. Fertilid's Favor, Halo Forger, Deep Root Wayfinder for a 2, Doomscar Warrior, you're at a 6, Excise the Imperfect, pretty good commander card, that is a 9, Finn, Tetsuko in the Halo, Voldaren Thrillseeker, so hold on. That does count? Yes. You're at a 12. And another Bruticlad. This is the Bruticlad box. That is an 18. So that is a 37 JA. All right, come on, Mythics. Come on, Ivy. Daniel, you're up. Seat of Hope. Invasion of Eldraine. The battle cards are a little clunky. I get what they're trying to do. They are a little clunky. Invasion of Gobakan, though, that's a good one. That's a 2. Ah, Shelly! Back to being the most expensive card in the set. In the regular set. So that is a 5 for Shelly in the, what do they call this? The Ichor treatment. So that is a 7 so far. Hey, there's a good commander card. Nesting Dovehawk. So that is an 11. Wow, what a pack so far. Yuri, Dina, and Rashmi and Raghavan for our second Commander Mythic. I'm going to add it up again. Hold on. Hey, all right. We got our next of the Multiverse Legend Mythics. We got Kenrith. Cool. Not a bad pack at all. Shelly, Gobakan, Nesting Dovehawk, Kenrith, and I guess Rashmi and Raghavan. What'd you have? Hold on. You had a 20. So you're at a 45, Daniel. Nice pack. So, you know, just so everybody knows, I mean, I sleeved up the Halo foils because they do have a little bit of a curling problem. So I kind of sleeved those up similar to some other treatments that tend to do that. All right, Jacob. Tommy of Whispered Hopes. If you've never played with this card in a counters deck, let me tell you. All right, Heliod for a 4. All right, Glissa. Call it Glizzy. That is a 9. Mist Metal Vanisher with the classic Lorwyn type artwork. Hold on, where were you at? 12. Valduk. Deeproot Wayfinder for a 14. And Karugos. It was going to happen eventually. We hit a Karuga, the Macro Sage companion. So hold on a second. What'd you have? That was a 19. This is going to be a tight last round. Yep. This is going to be an interesting last round. So put Sunfall back on top. Vincent, you're at a 44. J.A., you're still in the low at a 37. Daniel, you're in the high at a 45. And Jacob, you're at a 41. So far, nothing has been decided yet. So Vincent, left pack. Sword of Once in Future, which is kind of a rare hit out of these because it wasn't in any kind of extended arts or anything. So that is a 3. Thusk Legion Duelist for a 5 so far. Firemane Commando for a 9. Yargle. Rada. Om Nom 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 Neth. You are at a 14. Hey, an Aurelia the War Leader. Cool. In the foil etched. That's cool. I think that is a 20. And then we got the First Mate Ragavan token. Let me double check all that. Yep, that is easily a 20. That is a 64, Vincent. All right, J.A. Okay, let's see here. We got the Invasion of Pyrelia. Pylon for a 4. Progenitor Exarch, you're at a 5. All right. Hey, that is a good one. So you do tend to get a lot of commanders in these collector boxes. That is one of the two best ones you can pull. So that is Alenda and Azor. Nice pull. So I think you're at an 11. Yeah, an 11. Tetsuko. Rona. Mythic. Hey, Elish Norn showing up in the Ichor foil. Nice. Nice. So we got both Shelly and Elish Norn. Awesome. I'm going to re-add again. And Captain Lannery Storm in foil. Solid 2 mythic pack there. So hold on, what'd you have? An 18. That seems pretty low with everything we've been doing. You're at a 55, J.A. A 55. Daniel, you're up. I know some people have asked about me like making some kind of notation up here about where they're at, but I don't want to bring a pen anywhere near the cards. I hope people understand that. And also don't edit videos, so I'm not going to edit that on the screen. So there's that. All right, we got the Invasion of Tolvada. That is a 5. Errant and Giada, you're at an 8. Filigree Vector, okay, you're at a 14. Sorry, a 12. Agar. Finn. Doomscar Warrior, you're at a 16. And Eryximithes. Big ol' Slumber and Isle. I think that is a 20, but let me double check. Yeah, pretty simple math there. So Daniel, you are at a 65. A 65. So going into the last pack here, because frankly nothing's been determined. So Vincent, you're at a 64. J.A., you're in the low at a 55. Daniel, you're in the high at a 65. Jacob, you're at a 41 going into your last pack. You know, can we find like an Urbrask? That would the new Urbrask, that would really... Getting the top 3 Praetors out of this new set. That would be kind of cool. Oh, that's a good hit. All right, Tribute to the World Tree, which has been climbing up. That is a 3. And then the that's fantastic. That is lovely. That is a lovely 1-2 right there. That is 5. Elspeth's Talent for a 9. Inga. Oops. Raph. And it looks like we do have a companion. Kolga. Nope, it's Kolga and Yudaro. Looks like, because, yeah, it's the same type of cartoonish artwork. So where were you at? So you're at a 15. You're at a 15. All right. Rare? Oh, I hope I didn't jinx that. Nonetheless, it was a really good pack otherwise. Then we got Garuda, Doom of Depths. At least that is, I think that's the currently most played one in Commander. I think it is. Let's see here. What'd you have? Do math. Is that 21? That is a 62. Still, that is a heck of a 1-2 punch right there. All right, final scores. We got Vincent, you're at a 64. J.A., you're in the low, 55. Daniel, you're in the high at a 65. And Jacob, you finished at a 62. That was a pretty good box of March of the Machines, wasn't it? That's fun. Might have to do another one of those again next month. But that all depends on all of you. Well, actually, not all of you. Because if you are, and you heard me say that, then you're watching the video, in which case, great. So I guess it doesn't depend on you. I guess it depends on the general public of whether or not they want to watch March of the Machine. All right, Cruel Somnifuge. Oversold Cemetery. All right, come on, Peck. Ah, come on. Come on. Lord Skitter's Blessing. At least a decent card. And Pollen Shield Hair. Grasp of Fate. Yeah, Collector Vault. Okay, and then Daniel, let's do yours. Putting this back on top because I got to sleeve up that Elish Norn. And Daniel, here we go. Hey, Agatha, Extended Art Foil. Waste Not. Pretty good one too there to start. Devouring Sugar Maw. Loam Crafter Fawn. And Food Fight with a ground seal. And hey, up the beanstalk. There we go. Thank you for watching, folks. That was pretty fun, actually. I haven't touched March of the Machine in more than half a year. That's crazy to think about, but it's true. I did a whole lot of this set when it first came out, like a ton of it. And I kind of also burned myself out on it a little bit. That was a thing that happened. I just kind of didn't want to touch the set again. So what? After a long time goes by, it's fun again. Thank you for watching. Bye.